deserves a lot of applause. So please come on, let's give her an encouraging round of applause. His book, 13 Tales of the Paranormal. A world that our eyes refuse to see, our ears deny hearing, and our senses ignore the feel of. Now this is a book, ladies and gentlemen, for someone who is brave enough to take up this invitation to journey to uncharted waters along with the authors who are inspired by some bizarre experiences to pen down this work, where the lines of reality have been blurred by the footsteps of imagination. Each story... There you go. Faraz Kazi with his latest offering titled The Funny Side, The Other Side.
Just keep it aside. Look here, sir.
Come out and juggle so many roles.
Hello. Talking about roles, I'm playing another role here today. Actually, I'm more of a performer now. Your language show must go on. I happen to lose a very close friend of mine 3 days back, and I came to know about it this morning because she was abroad. So the news comes as a serious shock to me. She was named Arusha, and one of the characters in the book, in the story, that is the lady in the pub, the character is named after her. So I will dedicate this evening to her and the success of the book to her. Coming back to the book, I started off as a romance writer. So ultimately the book worked, it did well in the market, and people started tagging me as a romance brand. Whereas I beg to differ, because I refuse to be tagged as a genre specific writer. And horror was something I thought which was an uncharted territory in the Indian market as of yet. So not that there are not readers in India who read who don't read horror. So there are still Stephen King, still Dean Koontz, still being the highest selling horror writers internationally, even in the Indian market. So I was pretty surprised when I came to know that while Indian writers focusing on this genre as such, and to talk about it, India is a country where we have such a rich tradition, such a rich folklore of things, of stuff, that it's pretty surprising when that fact strikes you, that no one is operating in this genre. So I thought, let me be the first, And I took up the initiative. Vivek Banerjee, who happens to be the co-author. It's a pretty interesting fact for people to know that, we were just working, co-authoring on this project completely virtually. Okay, so we had nothing to do, we never met, except for 15 days back or 20 days back when Mr. Vikram had launched a book in the suburbs launch. So that was the first time I was actually meeting my co-author. So it was completely like virtual, on telephone, on email, stuff like that. So the other side, coming to the book, is a collection of 13 short stories, 13 being a number, generally associated with the background. And there are short stories in the prelude, the foreword, and the epilogue as well. So depends on how the reader takes it. All these stories have one thing in common, that they operate purely on the fear of the unknown. The fear of what lies beyond the realm of your senses, five senses cells. So, to better illustrate my point, I guess I should read out, a couple of passages from a story. So this story that I have picked up for today's reading is a story called The Man With No Fear. A couple of his friends. Now, Nirbhay gets into a bet with his two friends, and the bet so ends up in making him spend a night at the Moonlight Mansion. A mansion in Lonavala, okay, which is supposed to be haunted. Okay. And here's where I start. nightmare. Downstairs, a gong sounded. The grandfather clock had signaled the arrival of midnight. Moonless Mansion greeted midnight by extending the dark shadows from its corners far enough to reach everyone. As soon as his breathing returned to normal, he heard another sound, a softer one, that recorded in the silence. It repeated again after a second long pause. "It must be that cursed cat again," Wilbur said out aloud, thinking about venturing out to shoo it again. The sound came again. No cats. Don't make such sound. This was the noise of footsteps. Human footsteps. He could hear them clearly now, slowly ascending the stairs from the lower level. He could make out the distinct thud of the feet on the hard oak flooring. They seemed to come right up to his door, and suddenly the sound stopped. Nilbhai was pretty sure there was an intruder in the house, so he decided to investigate cautiously.
I don't read too much of our stories, but as you mentioned about the soaps, I think we use it to unnecessarily create an aura of horror and superstition, because as you have mentioned in your forward also in this book, that why do we get upset or in that fear that when a black cat crosses our path. So I think same way our daily soaps have been using for the last 10, 15 years, those drama, Sindhu ki Divya ke gayi to pata nahi ab kya hone wala hai, Dulhan ka pair ghar mein left ki wajah pehle right pad gaya to abhi kya hone wala hai. So I think daily soaps have been using to their own convenience, but I think what he has written for us is about the fear of unknown. I'm sure that we all must have experienced a lot of stories like this, spooky stories, or maybe when you're alone at home. There are people who cannot switch off all the lights and sleep. They have a tendency to, if they're alone at home, they have to have like lights on. So I asked one of my friends, I said, "Why do you do that? What difference does it make?" He said, "At least if somebody is planning to come or some ghost or something, they will be afraid because they think that there is somebody in the house. And if it's dark, I'm alone." Okay, to your own satisfaction. So, but I feel that as a story, whatever I have read of this book, I feel it will attract to people who are not very fond of horror stories also, because I think all the stories are different in nature. All the stories are not about ki bhoot aa gaya aur phir bhoot ne pakad liya aur ye kar diya. There is nothing like that. So there are stories which are very interesting as far as the drama is concerned. So you might get involved in the story and at the same time feel very scared also. Why I'm here today is because today is the first time I have met Faraz, but we have been, as he mentioned about his co-author, that they have been dealing on the internet. Same way we have been exchanging SMSs and phone calls about this book. And last release, the suburb release, I was supposed to come, but because of my shoot, I couldn't come. And this time, I promised him that I'll be here. And whatever I read about him, his work, and his credits, his education, I thought that somebody at his age, so young, has achieved and accomplished a lot. I think there needs some kind of a focus or mission that, I want to do this. Otherwise, triple post-graduation, an MBA, and writing second book, you need that kind of passion to do that. And that passion is in this book. You can very clearly see this, that when you go through all the stories. Why I started reading this book, because I'm very fond of short stories. So when he told me there are 30 stories, so I said, okay, if I don't like anyone, I can skip it. He said, yeah, sure, you can. But I think horror is something which we all experience every day in different ways. It depends on how we deal with it. But I would like to mention one incident. This director, I won't name him, he makes a lot of horror films. He said the horror is definitely, the scary part is that fear of unknown and all that we say. He said sometimes the fear of known is also very dangerous. I said, how? He said, imagine, if someone you know, the fear of a stranger is very much unknown, everything is there. Imagine you are living in the same house with your friend, and one day you just get up in the night to go to the washroom or something, and you see your friend sitting in the drawing room in the dark and just looking at you, staring at you. He said, that is more scarier than some stranger is sitting. I said, have you experienced it? He said, yeah, with my wife. So, no, he was not mentioning not the very, you know, husband-wife kind of joke, but he mentioned that sometimes it is, sometimes, you know, people you know, and if they behave in a certain manner, that's also very scary. So I think fear is something we all go through at different levels, and we have to overcome on their own. I was just telling Faraz, I said, he said, have you experienced anything like that? I said, never in my life. Abhi tak mere saath aisa nahi hua that, you know, koi bhoot ka story mere saath ho. But yes, I dream a lot. I told him, I said, when I'm sleeping, I feel that I'm dreaming all the time, even in the afternoon. Because when I get up, say, for example, if I'm sleeping for 2 hours, I wake up and I say, oh my God, I was in a dream. I think different people have, maybe I think too much, maybe I like my mind is too stressed. And I told him, I said, maybe because it's been 325 episodes of Crime Patrol and doing different kind of crime scenes and this, so that plays on my mind all the time. But I think fear is something we all experience and we all deal with it in our own way. But taking it very lightly and reading a story about horror is also fine.